and welcome to another edition of Ask Excite. I'm Tim Bushnell with Expert Cytometry, and today's question comes from Heidi. And Heidi asks, do you have any tips for compensating in DIVA? Now, Heidi, that's a great question because the DIVA program works very well for compensation, but it does drive you down a pathway that involves a universal negative. So after you've selected Create Compensation, you're going to get this box up here. And at the top, there's this checkbox that says, Include Separate Unstained Control. Uncheck that box. That way you will not have to collect an unstained sample, and the software will not use the unstained sample to collect compensation. A second powerful tip about DIVA is that if you have multiple fluorochromes in the same channel, you can add multiple fluorochromes down here and then label them rather than having this generic tag. And that will allow you to have tube-specific compensation based upon the antigens that you've chosen. Now, when you get to compensation, you get this typical window here where you've got your forward side scatter and then your plot here. The peak 2 or the P2, that's the gate generated by DIVA. This P3 is the gate that I generate. I add onto it. By putting that P3 gate on, it tells DIVA to use that as my negative control. So, big thing to do is remember to uncheck that box. Don't use universal negative and add the P3 gate on your histogram to ensure that you have the proper positive and negative in each tube. Now remember, if you have more questions, go to getflowtraining.com to learn more. You can always send your questions to askexcite@expertcytometry.com. Thanks for another Ask Excite. Until next time, be sure to keep up with the best practices in flow cytometry right here with me, Tim Bushnell, and Team Excite. Cheers.